There was blood and gore and trash on the floor. There was a rattle of chains and the creak of a door. Those size 13s reflected the light of the moon. They were calling to me, those haunted bowling shoes. You see, I had this uncle who I knew quite well. His name was Edgar Jr. and he owned a motel. I took a job there, though it was never formal. In less than a year, I'd witnessed the paranormal. One night a woman smelled something that stunk. So my uncle went to check out the source of the funk. When he came back, he told me the woman had a good nose. There was a dude nearby who had started to decompose. The man got an early checkout, watched him leave in a hearse. Little did we know, things were about to get worse. When I looked down, I saw my uncle's brand new kicks with a color combination I wouldn't have picked. There was blood and gore and trash on the floor. There was a rattle of chains and the creak of a door. Those size 13s reflected the light of the moon. They were calling to me, those haunted bowling shoes. For a few days it seemed like everything was fine, but then things started happening I couldn't define. The lights would flicker and the water would start and stop. It was the busiest time I ever had on the job. And one day my uncle was nowhere to be found. What if a ghost had got him and put him in the ground? I went up to his room to see what the trouble was. Then I saw Edgar had also bitten the dust. There was blood and gore and trash on the floor. There was a rattle of chains and the creak of a door. Those size 13s reflected the light of the moon. They were calling to me, those haunted bowling shoes. Bottom of his casket, shoes of green, blue, and pink. It's what my uncle would have wanted. Well, I think he wore them so much before his untimely demise. I thought I'd include them in the gravestone. Here my troubles were over with those damn shoes gone. Finally it was done and I could just move on. That's when I smelled something that I had smelled before. Went to the room in question and opened the door. They were up on the bed with the laces untied, stuck on the feet of another guest who had died. It threw me for a loop and I froze for a beat. Then like those ruby red slippers, they appeared on my feet. There was blood and gore and trash on the floor. There was a rattle of chains and the creak of a door. Those size 13s reflected the light of the moon. They were calling to me, those haunted bowling shoes. Some days later I found my uncle's will wasn't legal at all, but I read it still. It said I'd leave one thing to my beloved nephew. You best believe it was those fucking shoes.